Hey guys, your work career pairs, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool career mode where last time I left off. We picked up three huge wins against Real Madrid, Chelsea to win the Carling Cup, and Arsenal in the league. That just wasn't good enough to win us the league. But in this episode, we will win the league as long as we beat Swansea City. I'm not even going to be paying attention to the Chelsea game, because if I win, there's nothing they can do to stop me from winning the league. I will officially win the league. The first team is not able to play this match. There's no way that I could play them, because they'll just be super tired. They might get injured, and that's not what I'm going for here. I keep my players fit and win the league at the same time. The second team, more incapable of being in Swansea. It's not the full strength second team. There's no Jordan Ibe. He picked up a bit of an injury. He in training recently. He'll be out for a while. Timmans is exhausted, so I'm giving Martin Costa the second cam spot next to next to what is that? There's Sigurdsson for Swansea. Get the tackle in. There we go. No problem. Tiago Ilori. There is Altuzel. Come on. I know his name isn't pronounced Altuzel. Well, it's not spelled Altuzel. But I can't pronounce it, so that's what I'm calling him. You have a problem with that? Mute me. Or just hope he doesn't get the ball. There's Ings. Go on, Danny. Matt, you shithead. Going for 15th Premier League home win of the season. As to opposed to all those other wins that just didn't happen, I guess. I'm undefeated, 100% record. No draws, no losses. Only the goddamn goals conceded all season. This is breaking some sort of record. There has got to be a record I'm breaking, right? I mean, someone should compare this to the Arsenal Invincibles. I might be better than them at this point. How many goals did they concede? I know they didn't lose, but they drew some games, so. Oh, there's that. I'm gonna go all whole season undefeated. 100% record. That's the goal. Considering Neymar has only played half the season, and he's already on 15 goals, I wouldn't hold my breath for the other teams making much of a difference next season. So, yeah. They might want to look into vastly strengthening their team. Martin Costa! Oh! Right, young talent, Martin Costa. Just... score in there. Close though. You have to be given credit for that, doesn't it? Yes, that's a good work getting the ball. Oh, what is that? Riddle. The header! Oh, Danny! Oh, he was offside. It wouldn't have mattered. Oh, he's like a toenail offside or some shit. Oh, wow. How fucking close can you get? What's that? How did I not get there? Going around? Yes. What the hell? What? Fucking hell, I was not expecting that. He was offside anyway, so. Having a bit of trouble with the offside, this match so far. That's about 3 or 4 times I've been flagged offside so far. Come on, done, sir. Shot wasn't opening up. Here's Costa. Come on, oh! Ooh! Keeper had to make the save. Because that was going in. It took a deflection anyway, so it would have been a corner even if it wasn't going in. May have been an own goal if it was. Mm-hmm. That's another corner, I'll take that. Good work there by Donza. Alberto Moreno! Oh, and Kian is out for another corner. He is extremely lucky that that was not going in. Or that did go. So that would have been an own goal. There's the halftime whistle. Don't break through Ujesh yet, but I'm not worried. Not worried. A calm and collected. I'm gonna get that goal. Yes, one of the instantly making a mistake. Here's Danny Ings. He's Donza. Donza! There it is. Straight away. He just like Liverpool did to Sunderland in real life. He instantly at the start of the second half bangs it in the back of the net. 1-0. Oh, the league title is staying at Anfield. For another season, and another season, and another season. I'm untouchable. I'm untouchable. Seriously, they need to add some. In FIFA 17, they need to add a higher difficulty than Legendary, because Legendary is just, you know, sometimes the Legendary computer will give me a challenge. Sometimes it won't. But obviously, even though I've gotten good games from the Legendary computer for this season and last season, it's just not been good enough. Brito Bartley gets in the way. What's his help? Donza! Oh, I almost separates for Donza. Whoops it in. Oof. Will it fall as I had hoped? the scrambled spawns to get away here, scummies. Oh, that's probably gonna be a yellow card, isn't it? No? No? Huh. Bit of a surprise, thought that'd be a booking from the referee. He definitely looked like he was going for a card. So, forgive me. That's a no. Come on! Yes! Costa! How did you miss? How did he actually miss? I don't understand that. How did he miss? Like, that should be 2-0. I should be wrapped up. The title should be wrapped up. Instead, some of you are still very much in this. Unless Dobson's going through here. Why is he running away from the boys offside? That's why. Yeah, nice try, Swansea. I read what you were gonna do there. Ains, go on, Danny. Go on, Danny. It's being pulled back. Yes. Penalty. That is how you secure it. That probably should be a red card. That was gonna be a goal. Oh. Nice goal scoring opportunity there. And he might have been the last man as well. Hang on, let's look. Yeah, I was just about to shoot. He pulls Ings down in the penalty box. Definitely a penalty. No one's going to argue that. Hey, this is the most important penalty you're ever going to take in your life, friend. And he puts it away, 2-0. The league title is wrapped up. 2 years of a rough. Oh, I'm sorry, what? I am the best manager ever? Yes, I already knew that. You guys aren't here to tell me. Save your comments, don't bother. I know. You can still praise me, but I know. Number one. No questions. Because stupid questions don't need answers. Who's the best manager ever? Is it Jose Mourinho? No. Is it Ferguson? No. Oh, hell, it's not even Paisley or Shankly. It's Corey Peters. There's. If anyone asks, just say, how do you not already know this? Costa gets a league goal now. Oh, a stupid mistake by the Swansea player. Kamana, who gets the ball to Costa, and he smashes it in for 3-0. Just to rub extra salt into the Swansea wound. They didn't deserve this. They were just the sacrificial lamb. It was just... They were the team that the game picked for this match. The game decides the fixtures for Swansea. Yeah, I didn't want to embarrass you to join the title. Oh, I would have loved to have sealed it against Arsenal, but I'll take it. It's sealed against you. Who lot. But any day of the week, it doesn't really matter who I seal it against, as long as I win it. And I have. Which makes the Newcastle game pretty fucking pointless. Sorry, Georgie. Hey, boys. Is. But yeah. There it is. Pretty hell. Chelsea drew anyway, so they dropped points. I would have won it even if I didn't win. So, there's that. And there it is, at the bottom of your screen, on the the injuries to Lukaku and Marvius. Liverpool win. Barclays PL title. What needs to be said that hasn't already been said? I'm trying to think of why I could say that I've not already said. Just my goalkeeper. Wait, that's both goalkeepers have asked for new contracts this season. Makes sense. Actually, no, that's never happened ever. Or has it? Like, his Squadro is still squad rotation player. He's been my number one goalkeeper for two full seasons. you'd be much happier to see the crucial first team player, have ya? Life is good, dude. Life is good. Why not? Yeah. As I previously stated, this match does not matter. Sorry. Enjoy. I would love to play you guys in a game that actually matters, but that's just not the way life works sometimes. Where is... Ah, there it is. Let all the boys rest up for the up and coming fixtures. Get them nice and rested. Let the second team handle. But it doesn't. Like, that doesn't matter. It doesn't. Game is pointless. I'm so sorry, Newcastle. I would love if this match had some sort of meaning. I'm sure it means something. Newcastle, I'm sure they're still fighting for whatever they're fighting for. I'm not sure. I don't even know where they are in the league, to be honest. I was really only paying attention to me being in first. So let's see where they are. And then we'll know what they're buying for. Are they buying to avoid relegation? Are they trying to get up to 6th? Whoa, they are trying to avoid relegation. If it wasn't going for a perfect season in Newcastle, I'd help you out. I'm sorry, though. I don't have that perfect season, so, sorry. Gonna have to... But, yeah. Nothing personal. If I can win the league with a perfect season, I will. Who knows? Maybe Newcastle will beat me and make that all pointless. So, you know, it could happen. I mean, maybe I'm overconfident. Saying that I have a right to be confident. Just won the league. I've only conceded 4 goals all season. And I'm playing playing a team that's struggling against relegation. Which, probably sounds too familiar if you're a Newcastle fan as of late. Because that was the case last season, and it seems to be it's going to be the case this season. Fortunately, you can't play us every week. So, yeah. He can't play us every week. Full shift. Skigaya! Oof! Off the okay, that's a corner. So thank you very much, Mr. Chiyote. Rhino! Ooh, good save by Krul. Those safe hands. We all know him from the World Cup. let's think about that way. Can you imagine if a Premier League team or some big team did that? They brought on a better keeper for a penalty shootout. How mad would that be? People would be like, oh, it's the Van Gaal tactic! It's the Van Gaal tactic! You could actually call it that. Be the only thing anyone would want to name after Louis Van Gaal at the moment, to be honest. That or they renamed the 0-0 draw the Louis Van Gaal game. Because he fucking loves a 0-0 draw, doesn't he? Although, you gotta admire his complete fucking insanity. Because he came out there a couple of days ago and said that if Man United don't win against Swansea, you can count out their title hopes. And I'm like, what are you smoking? You had no chance of winning the league. Leicester actually do have a better chance of winning the league. No one is expecting them to stay up there, but yeah, they have a better chance of winning the league. Spurs have a better chance of winning the league. Hell, I'd go as far as to say Watford would probably have a better chance of winning the league than Man United. Man United will not win the league this season. I'd be surprised if they get into your Europa League spot. But with the way they're going. Oh, come on, Ings. How did you miss that? It's okay. Neves scored it. It's back in the starting lineup. He is such a good player. It's hard. You wouldn't believe he is the age that he is with the way he plays. He's just awesome. It's mind-boggling, really. There we go, 1-0. Here comes Newcastle. Here's TOT. And Tiedemann's a light. Yeah, no. Another. Oops, sorry, pressed the wrong button. So, come on up. Pass. It's offside again. Come on, Danny. Fuck's sake. We had enough of this last game. Got my can of Diet Coke. Better problem. The placement? Why not? The second half. See if I can't do anything against Swansea. Nope, Gene Wijnaldum takes it straight off of Neves. This Cisse back to Wijnaldum. There's now Mbemba. Who's someone I looked at as a possible signing in another career mode, but then I realised he is new at Newcastle, so I wouldn't be able to sign him. So I'll leave him where he is. So don't worry, Newcastle fans. You won't see me going after him in a career mode. Maybe next FIFA. If he's still at Newcastle, well then. And chances are, if you do go down, he might want to leave. It's just the unfortunate truth. When teams go down, they have a really high chance of losing some of the better players. So, Newcastle, if you do go down, you might be saying goodbye to the likes of Wijnaldum and Krul. I definitely worry about Krul, even though he's injured at the moment. Everyone knows Krul is an amazing keeper. Any team would be happy to get him. And it's easy to see teams wanting people who's done it. I'd love Krul at Liverpool because he'd be better than fucking Nuno. I said this before. But so. Brannigan? How the hell did he score? Connor Brannigan. And out of nowhere, I randomly picked him to play, and he has scored his first ever goal for Liverpool. Oh. And I am including real life. He might have goals for the youth team, but he definitely has no goals for the main team. He hardly ever played for the main team, even in cup games. But yeah, in what I think is like only the second time I've ever played him, and he scores a goal. That would get, a memorable goal. Newcastle is one of the recognizable teams in the Premier League. You would know the Joeys. They're always that. Even though Newcastle have been reggae a few times, they always come back. And if you do go down, I have no worries that you'll be back before we know it. You can't keep a good team down, and when they try their best, Newcastle are a good team. I'm sure a lot of Newcastle fans would be like, when were you last watching Newcastle? Hey, be us, so. You're a good team in my book. It doesn't apply to every team that beat us this season, though. Man United just got lucky because Brendan Rodgers played the wrong formation. We will see how that match, how the reverse fixture goes when we play later in the season. I'm expecting a much different result. Domet gets it away. Camano crosses blocked. I think it was Cabella actually who just came on. He blocked it. Mitrovic. Someone else Newcastle might be forced to part with if they are relegated. He's a good player when he's not, getting booked after however long it takes him to get booked. Whether it be 90 seconds or fucking like 10 seconds was it in his first match when he came on there towards the beginning of the season. See, at the very beginning of the season. Bristow! Hey, it didn't matter anyway. 3-0 win. Again, sorry Newcastle, it was nothing personal. Well, Tim Crow had a hell of a game though. So that. But yeah. 3-0. Job done. And the next episode, games against Derby and that all important second leg against Real Madrid. Don't miss it, or you'll regret it. Because trust me, those games are going to be something special. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Like the video if you did. Subscribe for more. And I will see you all next time.